A Northern Light show returns to the Minnesota skies tonight. The Aurora Borealis doing a repeat of its stellar appearance from Friday, although perhaps not quite as brilliant this time around. Richard Reeve is live at the Bell Museum to explain why we're seeing those lights in the sky pop up now and how you can best see them, Rich.
Yeah, Callan, staffers here at the Bell Museum, very excited about this. This is the best viewing, they say, in the last 20 years. And you folks out there, our viewers, sent us some amazing pictures.
It's a brilliant and beautiful celestial light show in the night sky.
I've never really seen them in person, but they were pretty cool to see.
11-year-old Rylan Hines, his mom Megan, and big sister Taylan took these pictures of the Northern Lights Friday night near their cabin in Amory, Wisconsin.
It was really cool because the Big Dipper was in it and sat there for a while. And then we drove probably about another 10 minutes and got to the cabin and went out on the dock, and they were just everywhere.
The show even better without light pollution. Check out this time lapse from the Superior National Forest near Ely.
Looking and finding pretty things in the sky is the hobby.
Matt Vinge is an aurora chaser from St. Paul.
My neck hurt after about an hour of just staring straight up.
He drove north and stayed up pretty much the whole night, snapping these images in yellow and purple and pink.
It's been described as fire, but I don't think fire is not right. It's more electricity, and shooting electricity, it's crazy.
Scientists say this cacophony of color is caused by solar flares shooting charged particles at the Earth.
It's space weather, not just Earth weather, but space weather.
Sally Brummel with the Bell Museum says our planet's magnetic field protects us. She explains those particles interact with gases in the atmosphere, triggering a geomagnetic storm. And the light show begins.
So the colors have to do with the different atoms in our atmosphere. So the particles are colliding with the atoms and exciting them, and that gives off light.
Green means the particles are colliding with oxygen, purple with nitrogen, and red a high altitude. These shimmering shades of light, 150 miles above us, although it might feel like you can touch them.
It's like there's a big sheet in the sky that's moving every which way. It's a really magical thing.
Matt Surwee tells me the best viewing will be likely tonight between 1 a.m. and sunrise. A good rule of thumb to keep away from that light pollution. That's the best chance you'll have a good view of those northern lights. Reporting live, Richard Reeve, Eyewitness News on 45.
A great excuse to stay up late. Thanks, Rich.